What's up, guys? This is it's going to be the first of my reviews for my Comic-Con stuff. Just real quick, the list of things that I got. The Deadpool taco truck, the NECA Jason Friday the 13th figure, the Deadpool Deadpool's Assemble mini-mates, and Jane Silent Bob mini-mates. I've got the Gundam Unicorn exclusive, the show exclusive, with the green, like, light up bits or whatever. I got Metroplex, the Comic-Con Metroplex. I got, I didn't get any Bishojo. That's kind of a disappointment, but, incidentally, Kodo didn't have, any ones that I wanted at their booth, and I didn't pick up Harley Quinn. I decided to pass on her and, spend my money elsewhere. I don't need a Harley Quinn with a different head. If it was another X-23 with another head, I would have been waiting in line for it, but not really the biggest Harley fan, so that was a pass for me, unfortunately. I also got the G.I. Joe Transformers crossover set with Jet Firehound, Snake Eyes, Ravage, Bludgeon, and Baroness, and I guess Blaster. I think that's about it for figures, I want to say. I don't think I got anything else, so. Here is Trouble, or Forte. I'm not as familiar with these characters, with the Japanese versions of them anyway. But D-Arts Forte, this is the box they come in. And then the actual box is inside of this. Oops. Let's get that out of here. So here they are. Looking at them inside the case was pretty impressive. They looked really cool. And I knew going into it that I was going to pick them up, but when I seen them, I was kind of excited because Trouble looks awesome. Base is good too, but I'm sure once we get these open and take a look, it'll be pretty obvious that Trouble is going to be stealing most of the attention. All right, let's take a look at him. All right, so here he is inside his little carton here. As far as his accessory goes, he comes with two faces. Well, three faces, technically, two extra faces. I swapped out one already. This is actually the default face here. That is not. Comes with two blaster hands, two regular hands, or I should say blaster arms and regular arms, and then he's got two fists, two open hands, just like X's, kind of that open hand. And then he's got one that's kind of pointing, I'm guessing kind of as a gesture to Trouble to go do his thing. That's what that looks like to me. All right, so let's start with Trouble. Trouble's very cool looking. The paint job is done very well. But unfortunately, he's not very articulated. Less so than Rush. Definitely less than Rush. He's basically got 5 points of articulation, as best I can tell. Which is, all four of his legs move at the hip, but they don't move at the ankle. Or I should say the elbow or the ankle. Now, Rush basically had this same articulation, except he had a ball joint right here in the elbow that basically made him be able to sit or lean forward or stand up straight. With this guy, basically, your options are pretty limited. They're movable, but I don't really know why, other than maybe to lift his leg to pee on something or something along those lines. But because he's not articulated at the elbow, it doesn't really give you any other posing options other than, like I say, lifting the leg or, I don't know, standing up on his hind legs for some reason, maybe like that, or laying out. But that's it. And then the other point of articulation is his head. And his head looks like it's double-jointed, or has two ball joints, but it's not. It's actually, I don't even think, one ball joint. His head doesn't go up and down very much, but it goes up enough that it feels like it could be articulated a little bit. So there's a little range of motion there. You can go up to about here and down to about there. I'm not sure what kind of difference that would make, but his head does spin around. If you get his mane here clear of his feet. His head will spin all the way around. That's about it. Not much side to side. A little bit, but not much. A little bit. And that's it for articulation on him. So, not very articulated. For me, it doesn't amount to anything. I don't even really care about that, to be completely honest, in this instance, because this is exactly how I want him to look, basically. Tail's also not articulated, as best I can tell. I'm not trying to push on it too hard, but it does not look like it's articulated at all. But he's got the little jewel piece in there, just like all the other blasters that you've seen in this line. Not on his ankles, where it looks like he might have it. That's actually just metallic paint inside there. There's no plastic lens in there like there is in his tail or in other blasters. Get a good look at his face here. Pretty well done. He looks a little goofy straight on, but most characters, cartoon characters, video game characters, have a tendency to have that happen to them. Very nice purple. It's reminiscent of the Vile purple. I want to say that it looks different, but maybe we'll see here in a minute. But done pretty well. Flat blue, flat yellow. Kind of an odd mix with all the purple and the metallic black. The black on him is also metallic looking. It's got the same kind of treatment that Bass himself got. So there's Trouble. Very cool, though, for my purposes. I think he's great. So, Bass himself. Unfortunately, Bass has a couple of problems. I don't know if it's what's going on, why this is the case, but his shoulder pads are very flimsy. Now, they'll stay attached, and they won't, like, shake off or come off, but if you move them, put enough pressure on them, they'll pop right off. And it doesn't take much. I tried swapping them from one shoulder to the next, hoping that maybe you get a better fit, but they're molded specifically for each shoulder, so no go there. As far as articulation goes, he's got a double ball jointed neck. It lets him do that. And he's got a ball jointed shoulder. It's set inside of his chest in a ball joint. So there's that. Get my focus on here. And then the shoulder itself is just kind of a swivel hinge. And then it's got a rotating bicep. It's got a double hinged elbow. But, like I say, pieces tend to pop off of him pretty easily. His shoulder pads pop off really easy, and his arms don't seem to hold on very well. Not as well as X. And I don't know about Zero. Unfortunately, I never got around to reviewing him or even taking him out of his box. But this is definitely a step down from X quality-wise, which is unfortunate. And also a step down for Vile. Vile was made better than this, too. He's just got a couple of issues like that, where his parts don't want to stay on very well. But after his shoulder pads and his forearms go, everything else is pretty tight. His hands stay on pretty well. His head definitely is fine. Articulation's a little loose in his head, but not bad. He'll hold pretty much any pose you want. He will. Not pretty much, he will. So far, so good with that. He's got a double jointed torso, so he's got the kind of a waist ball joint and an upper torso ball joint in his chest, and he's got a good range of motion out of that. You can see there. I'm guessing that's pretty much due to the mold and the way it kind of comes up there underneath his arms. But you get a good range of motions out of him because of that. The double-jointed elbow has this little sleeve here that kind of moves. This is kind of what the D-Arts line and kind of some of the new Bandai figures have. They kind of have these little bits that conceal joints and things like that. And it works pretty good. You just have to remember that they're there. Sometimes you can end up posing someone that like this when you could have that joint concealed a little better like that. And have his armor pop off as well. Good range of motion out of him pretty much everywhere. I think that's what he's got over X. X doesn't seem to have quite as good of range of motion. Certainly not in the torso. Matter of fact, X was so limited in the torso that it almost seemed pointless that he was double ball jointed in the torso. From the waist down, he's got pretty much the exact same articulation as X and Zero and Vile, which is double-jointed knees, fold all the way up like that, which is great. That's considering how big his leg is and how small his, how big his calf is in the bottom part of his boot compared to the top of his leg, the fact that they fold up right up against each other, I think Bandai should be commended for that. That's impressive. So there's the inside of his leg. Double-jointed, great range of motion, and still maintaining some decent aesthetics without looking like it just he's come apart. And then he's got double ball-jointed ankles, so they kind of move forward at the top of the ankle and at the bottom of the ankle. So very cool. He's also got the same kind of plastic jewel at the bottom of his feet, like all the other guys have had. Focus, thank you. And that looks good. He does have some paint issues, though. Mine's not perfect. You can see the kind of V in his belt there. Not a little spotty, not perfect. You definitely see a big fat seam right here. That's not great.
So I just finished my review, and I'll be a son of a Vondruk if I didn't forget to do the size comparison. So, here he is with D-Art's Mega Man. It's just kind of the regular Mega Man. This is the same series that I'm guessing Bass is from, so kind of the most appropriate comparison to make, I think. So there's him. They size up pretty well together. And then Rush to go along with him. So there's Rush and Trouble together. Rush is far more articulated than Trouble is, unfortunately. But it's a good thing he is, because if it was the other way around, Rush would really be kind of a lame one. And then here he is with X. The Comic-Con X. Sorry, X has been posed like this for a little while. Let me get him in a more comparable position here. So you can see he's a little undersized compared to Mega Man X, but all in all, he's a pretty good size figure. I'm looking forward to a Proto Man too, like this. Anyway, now that I've shoved this awkwardly into the middle of the video, I'll let the video resume.
He's got a little bit of a, I'm not sure what this is called. It's like a little dimple from in the plastic from where he's cut off of the sprue or the tree. It's a little sloppy looking to have it be right there on the bicep. Makes me wonder why they had to cut it off right there. Seems like an odd place to put it. Not really much can be done about that, unfortunately. And his jewel on his chest is a very nice deep blue, same as the one on his head. It's very dark, though. Without the lights on it, you probably wouldn't even know it was there on his head. On his chest, it's a little more obvious, but not very. But looks very good. He's also got his the paint, the black paint, the metallic paint looks good. The yellow paint, though, is the application is a little spotty here and there. For instance, on one of his other hands here. You can see there. Same deal. You can see a big seam in the middle. The paint's a little ragged at the edge. Not bad, but not great either. Kind of fades away at the top of the little spike there on the right side. So, not perfect paint. So it's a little lacking in that department. So, let's go move on to his head. Now, his head comes apart in a pretty cool way in that the seams in his head where he comes apart are pretty well concealed. Unfortunately, he does have kind of a seam on the back here where just it was molded. So that's kind of unfortunate. I feel like that could have been remedied somehow. But his kind of headdress here pops off straight up. It's got a couple of pegs on the inside. All right. And then a couple of peg holes on the top of his head. Looks pretty funny this way. And then his head splits right in the middle here. Kind of hard to get the seam open, but that's a good thing. Because if it was open and it was easy, then it would look pretty terrible. So that comes off there. There's his mask. All right. He does have the little jewel on the side of his mask, though. His helmet, so that's cool. They didn't skimp there. And that's all painted pretty well. So his face, one of his faces pop off here. Has a little slot right there that pegs into the back of his head. And then you can pop in another face here. We'll do this one. His suspicion, he looks suspicious at Trouble. Like, what? I think this dog has eaten too much robo chili. I'm not sure what dogs eat, robot dogs, if they eat anything. But it doesn't look happy with him. Alright, so there's that. Pop the headdress back on, and he's looking pretty good. The seams are all pretty much concealed. So, he's got two different hands. You can interchange these however you want. He's got two blaster hands. He's got two blaster arms and two arms that will hold hands in them. Whoops. There we go. These things pop off pretty easily. That was completely inadvertent. I was not trying to do that, but it popped off. So let's put on another hand here. See what that looks like. These, as tricky as these are, they're actually easier than on Mega Man X, at least on mine. Mine's pretty tough. He's a stubborn guy. All right, pop a hand off of here. And there you have base. There goes his other shoulder armor. Man. Well, once they're on, they'll stay put once he's posed, but, you know, they're not going to pop off spontaneously, but, man, they really come off easy. So, you know, on that note, I wouldn't recommend this for a kid. If you want to pick this up for your kid and you're worried about that they might lose parts to them or something like that, I think you could probably spend your money elsewhere and get a little more bang for your buck. Vile here was about $30, and cool figure for me because I don't really have a problem with it. Once he's in my case, he's going to be just fine. But there they are. Pretty cool figures, I must say. I'm very happy to have these guys. I think they look great. They have a couple of issues, but nothing too serious that would bar a recommendation. So, there they are, Base and Trouble. Thanks for checking me out. I've got a whole bunch of other reviews to do, so stay tuned. I'll get to them as soon as I can. I'm still working. I had to work today. I would have put this up sooner, but that is my life. So, thanks for checking me out. Stay tuned for the rest, and let me know what you think about Base and Trouble here, and whether or not you have him, and if yours has any of the issues mine has. And how my paint stacks up to yours. If I got better paint than you, let me know, because that'll make me happy. Thanks, guys, for watching, and I'll see you next time.